the American Civil Liberties Union of Massachusetts. We as the ACLU champion freedom of speech, the freedom of religion, and women's rights. Now, just last week, five men on the Supreme Court told us that they too champion the freedom of speech and freedom of religion. But to that I say, not so. Five men on the court want us to believe that the freedom of speech and freedom of religion are incompatible with women's rights. They want us to believe that these freedoms are about imposing your will upon others and depriving women of our rights as full citizens. We at the ACLU wholly reject this. This is not what the freedom of speech and the freedom of religion look like. We refuse to accept that women must be reduced to second-class citizens in order to protect these freedoms. We deserve better, and we must demand better. We must stop waiting for five men on the court to recognize our personhood. Before the rights of women. We will not seek justice from a court that time and time again refuses to recognize our right to equal and meaningful protection under the laws. Our rights to control our bodies and have access to reproductive health care is in harmony, not at odds, with the freedom of speech and the freedom of religion. Now, let me be clear that this is not just about access. Five men on the Supreme Court have made it their mission to reduce us to second-class citizens, not just through our bodies, but also through our ability to participate equally in the labor market. Just last week, there was a third decision. In Harris v. Quinn, the court further limited the right of low-wage home health care workers to organize. The majority of these women are poor women of color. This makes it more difficult for these women to demand equal treatment in the workplace and to provide for themselves and their families. So, I say again, we cannot be silent about our use of contraception. We cannot be silent about seeking abortions. And we shall not be silent about our right to participate equally in the labor market. We will no longer be shamed about exercising and demanding our fundamental civil rights. Together and demand that the laws already on the books, like the federal and state access to clinic laws and our own emergency contraception laws, be enforced vigorously. We must talk openly with our friends and loved ones about our use of contraception and our use of abortions so that these topics will no longer be taboo. Treatment in the workplace. We will be heard in our homes, in the streets, in the legislature, and in the court, and most importantly, we will demand